In 1970, soul jazz organist Jimmy McGriff released the album Soul Sugar, and from it, the track New Volume. Haunting, simple organ melody over a descending bass line, kind of a pipey early 60s organ. I like that triangle, like ding. Yeah, and kind of a Latin rock vibe, a mellow Latin rock acid vibe, paired with that earlier 60s organ, a unique combination there. To make a banal simile, it's kind of like some world where House of the Rising Sun meets Santana, you know, kind of an unrealized direction of 60s music. And how appropriate. Get real food. To pick up from that fluty organ. This is a Jimmy McGriff original, though. Yeah, I've looked at six of the nine entries on Discogs for this title. None of them tell us who's playing what, other than what Jimmy McGriff is obviously playing. Yeah. Like voodoo music. By him, he really plays up the atmosphere, the atmospheric potential of that organ, like on this one. It's definitely influenced by psychedelia, because they weren't really, soul jazz wasn't really, it didn't really occur to them to treat it as like an atmosphere. It was always treated as like a rhythmic instrument during the like earlier 60s, rather than like one of just sonic potential, like they're doing it here. Yeah, that was a new volume by Jimmy McGriff from his 1970 album, Soul Sugar. I believe his 20th or so overall. Yeah, giving us music that could be used in like a snake charmer scene or in a voodoo or... I love how it kind of bridges the gap between exotica and soul jazz, that era, and the psychedelic era and Latin rock. Yeah, it's like 1960 meets 1970. in some like sonic chronospace. Yeah, let's hear another track from the album, Dig It. Like the Meters, early Meters, like from around this time period. Or also kind of like a soul strut. Yeah, Young, Holt, and Limited. But that snaky little guitar, just little vibrato to it, those thin little lines, mixing with that like refined little organ. That the horns are really dominant, of course, really kind of blaring over everything. I appreciate how circular that bass is too. You have to listen for it, or you might get distracted by other things. But I love how it keeps it going. Boom, 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 boom. Really, just circling around everything. Two guitarists here, one just playing kind of a scratchy riff and the other playing these like these bendy triads. Everyone being so economical and just putting in light little droplets of sound, and it's all just adds up to the sum of its parts. And of course the percussion being really dominant during this section. Quite a strong melody though, it's coming together from all these parts. Now the organ is kind of like fighting to like assert itself above everything. Dig On It by Jimmy McGriff from his 1970 release Soul Sugar. Let's hear one more track, Bug Out. Spray. once again, I really appreciate the choice staccato notes that the electric bass is giving us, even though it's low in the mix. Take this organ out of the just kind of 12 bar blues context, and some of these passages could fit right in with what was going on with some of the like organ rock bands overseas. Icy sustains on that organ, and those notes, the way they were like those bass notes, the way they were scaling up those really tight staccato kind of dotty bass lines on that electric. I wonder how far back electric bass was being used in soul jazz. That has me wondering. Psychedelic soul jazz from a guy who had been cranking it out since the early 1960s. That is the 1970 release Soul Sugar, the track Bug Out, before that Dig On It, and before that a new volume by Jimmy McGriff. 34 years old in 1970 and yet all current and completely up to date on the new electrified psychedelic jazz sounds. Yeah, and also very much retaining some of his like earlier 60s character in there as well. Makes me want to go and listen to some more of those 60s instrumentals, like from like the R&B scene. Like I kind of like start at the tail end of the 60s on a lot of that music and trace it through the 70s, but yeah. This makes me want to go back to like 1960 and hear more like that Booker T and the MGs and stuff in that vein some of which led to it tended to be like the R&B instrumental groups of the 60s that paved way for funk, and some of its musicians went on to play funk, and it tended to be the soul jazz players and post-bop players that ended up going into like electrified jazz funk in the early 70s. This I'm hearing kind of both like some of that instrumental R&B of the 60s and the soul jazz and psychedelic, and on the first track anyway, Latin rock, yeah. And some breaks that I could even imagine some of the German hard rock psychedelic bands using, or like English bands like organ trios and such. Yeah. Anyway, Jimmy McGriff, guy who had a long Oh, discography, dating back, let's see, 1962, I guess is his first album. I've Got a Woman, and then about three albums a year up through the early 70s anyway. And if you count live albums, I think this Soul Sugar was his 21st release, yeah. And he would put out a few more like jazz funk classics during the 1970s that had become popular in rare groove circles, like the 1976 release Red Beans. For more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Jimmy McGriff for the jazz funk period anyway, see the directory of albums by American jazz funk artists linked in the description below. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the three tracks we just heard. The interplay, the layers, the instrumentation, the counterpoint, the nuances, the detail, and some information on who played what if you have access to that information. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most dear travel trim expert, signing off.